At this time, I would like to introduce Pastor Nguyen. Every time I call on Pastor Nguyen to come speak to our students, it's always yes. And he always leaves a very positive message with our students. He gives back to our students. So at this time, everyone will welcome Pastor Nguyen.
Privilege to be here, and as Dr. Taylor said, whenever she calls, my answer is yes, because I have a great respect for her and her work, and I've fallen in love with this school. I won't be before you long. My thought today is this: what do you believe in? Say that with me. Say, what do you believe in? Now, I want to drop some facts on you, and then I want to share something with you that's powerful. They tell us that from childhood to the age of 25 years old, it's said to be the period of gathering resources. It's what they call the learning years. Somebody say the learning years. What's crazy about the learning years is that by the time you reach 25, you have a foundation in place for the rest of your life. That foundation is what you're going to build your entire life on. What's crazy about foundations is foundations don't get the credit they deserve. As we sit in this amazing, beautiful gym, we can see the ceiling, we can see the floor, we can see the bleachers, but the most important part of this gym is invisible. The most important part of this gym we cannot see, and it is called the foundation. And if you don't think the foundation is important, let the foundation get a crack. If you don't think the foundation is important, let the foundation fall, and when the foundation falls, everything on the foundation goes with it. I stopped by to tell you today that Black history is not just the history of Black people. Black history is everybody's history. When you study Black history, you have to recognize that Black history would not be in place if it were not for all of the other races of people who supported the movement for civil rights. So whether you're Black, whether you're white, blue, or green, whatever your race is today, I need you to understand something. We are in this together. Somebody say, we're in this together. Say, I will not waste my youthful years. Now, I will tell you that I am on the precipice. In other words, I'm right on the edge of celebrating my 55th birthday in a couple of months. Thank you for your kindness. And I appreciate you clapping, but I'm kind of in a mixed place because I remember when I thought 40 was old. I remember my father celebrating his 40th birthday, and I was about 20 years old, and I looked at my dad and said, boy, you're old. Here's what I found out about life. Life doesn't wait on anybody. And I know you might think that school is irrelevant sometimes and you can't wait for it to be over, but I want to encourage every young person to recognize you cannot waste this time, because this time will be the time that your foundation gets built. This is the time that your foundation is solid. And when you think about Black history, you got to look back and see all the things that those individuals that we talk about all the time have accomplished. People like Harriet Tubman. I love Harriet Tubman because she broke free from slavery, but had the audacity to come back and save other people. I think about people like Dr. Martin Luther King, who sacrificed his life and the life of his children and his family so that you and I could enjoy many of the great privileges today. I need you to understand that in this room, there is another Dr. Martin Luther King. In this room, there is another great person who's going to lead our community. I want to ask you the question, though, is it you? Ask your neighbor, is it you? What did they say? So here's the question. What kind of history are you making? You know, we celebrate Dr. Taylor today, and I've gotten a lot of mixed emotions because I just found out last night that she is going to be leaving our school system. She's going to be leaving Huntington Middle School. And I don't know if you guys recognize, but we have a pioneer in our presence. We have a real history maker in our presence. And listen, I'm telling you something. You can look at her life and know that anything is possible if you put your mind to it. Here's what I know about making history, though. Everybody's not going to like you. But when you've been called to make a difference, you can't be worried about who likes you and who don't like you, because somebody needs you to make a difference for the future generations. Somebody say, I will make a difference. What kind of history are you making? What kind of history are you making right here, right now? Will you be remembered 20 years from now? If so, what will you be remembered for? The only thing that's going to matter 20 years from now is what difference did you make? I need you to understand something, that we need you. We need every young person under the sound of my voice to recognize that you are somebody, to recognize that you are important, and to recognize it doesn't matter where you come from. The only thing that matters is where you're going. Give me a clap if you're feeling what I'm saying. Somebody say, I will make a difference. Come on, say it with your chest. Say, I will make a difference. I like that. Say every face. Say every face has an equal place at the family table of the human race. Say every face. Oh, I like that. Has a place at the family table of the human race. How many of you remember Thanksgiving dinner or Christmas dinner when all your family come along? And this is how I grew up. There were always two tables. There was the grown folks table. Oh, I got some people feeling me now. And then there was the little kiddie table. And I'm going to tell you something about me. I hated sitting at the kiddie table. Seemed like at the kiddie table, you got the leftovers. Seemed like at the kiddie table, you was the second thought. But at the grown folks table, everything was there. Here's what I need you to know. Life is a moving transition. And many of you right now are sitting at a proverbial kiddie table. You're in middle school, then you're going to go to high school, and then you're going to make some major decisions. But I need every one of you to understand something. There's going to come a day that you're going to be the ones that are in charge. There's going to come a day that you're going to be the one sitting at the adult table. Here's what kids don't understand about the adult table. The adults at the adult table are the reason why there's food on any table. The adults at the adult table are the reason why there's food on any table. What are you trying to tell me, Pastor Troy? You got to put your mind in gear to say, when it's time for me to sit at the table, I don't just want to sit at the table. I want to put something on the table. I want to put something on the table for my family. I want to put something on the table for my peers. I want to put something on the table so that when they say my name, they recognize that I made history. Make some noise if you're feeling it. What kind of history are you making? Now, my starting question was, what do you believe in? I need you to recognize every young person that you must believe in yourself. You must believe in yourself enough to know that you can make a difference, that you matter, and that you are a history maker. Do I have anybody in this room that believes in themselves and know one day you're going to make a difference? Do you believe in yourself and know that no matter where you come from, you're going to be somebody one day? Then make some crazy noise if you're going to make a difference. What do you believe in? I'll leave you with this thought, and I need everybody to hear me. You say, the things we believe in, we build. You missed it. The things we believe in, we build. Watch this. Don't say it, just hear it. The things we doubt, you didn't have to say it, but I appreciate it. The things we doubt, we destroy. Now, I just said $1 million word and most of you missed it. The things we believe in, we build. The things we doubt, we destroy. If you are throwing away your education, it's because you don't believe in education. If you're one of those kids in here who goes to class but you don't ever turn in your homework and you give the teacher a hard time every day, and you come to school for lunch and social activities, the reason why you do that is because you doubt yourself. Because anything you believe in, you do what? You build. I'm challenging you today. I'm challenging you this year to believe in yourself enough to make a difference. Believe in your education. Believe in your reputation. And believe in your foundation. Because if you doubt it, you'll destroy it. But if you believe in it, you will build it. Clap your hands if you understand half of what I said. What do you believe in? Somebody say me. What do you believe in? Say me. What do you believe in? What do you believe in? What do you believe in? Now make some noise. I'm done. Come on. I believe in you. I'm here with Dr. Gwendolyn Taylor at Huntington Middle School. Just finished speaking here again. One of my favorite places to speak, one of my favorite people, and I asked her to just talk about me coming to the schools to speak and what she thinks about.
Wow, what a powerful motivational speaker for your students. Any topic, he will fire up your students. They will listen and he will leave a powerful message. So reach out to Pastor Troy for that powerful message. The man with the message.
Thank you, Dr. Taylor.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.